Hello guys, this is the Freeplay Dude, and welcome again for another video in Epic 7. Today, it's gonna be the Christmas RTA tier list, or Early Conviction Season tier list, and I'm gonna talk about the RTA meta right now, but before we start, this is gonna be my complete opinion, so if you disagree on some heroes, it's fine, or if you don't see a hero you use, doesn't mean it's unusable. I've only put in the heroes that define the meta, in my opinion, and I've been as cynic as possible. I've divided them into 5 tiers, and I'm gonna briefly talk about all of them, so we can see the picture as quick as possible. If you like the video, please remember to leave a like or subscribe, it's gonna help a lot. We are over 700 subs now, thank you so much for the support, guys, and that said, let's start with the tier list. First tier is gonna be the broken tier. These are the most broken heroes right now in RTA, and at least they are only 3. First one is Apocalypse Ravi, she's probably the best hero in the game right now. She's super tanky, counter cleaves, bruisers, counter control, because she's super hard to control thanks to Crimson Seed and the turn cycles. She heals a lot, she revives, she's pretty much a boss. Second one, Mulet Kavarik, from the worst Mulet 5-star in the game, he's now the best support in the game. He's extremely hard to control, he cleans everything, gives attack buff, immunity for 2 turns, a barrier, a strip. It's just insane! It's so annoying to deal with. Next, we have the most hated hero in the game right now, Angel of Light. She's probably the most banned unit in RTA, just cannot use her at all, she's always banned. She counter cleaves, bruisers, she's pretty much good everywhere. The only answer for her is Politis for now, but yeah, that's only one answer. Next, we have the meta tier list. Those are all the meta heroes that you're gonna see probably 70-80% of the matches. And the first one is gonna be Fallen Cecilia. This hero doesn't give a crap about power creeping. She was super strong on the release, she's super strong now, she's just the best knight in the game. Next is Rimuru. I don't have problems fighting this guy because I use a lot of unbuffable units, but he's super strong against everything else. If you use buffs on your team, he's gonna be a pain for you. Next we have Belian, one of the best and more flexible units in the game. This hero has 3 different builds, speed, counter or injury set, and all of them are super meta. Next we have Maid Chloe, she has fallen off a little bit from when the Rimuru went in the game, but she's just so solid. She cleans, revive, attack buff, she heals a lot with the passive, and she can randomly stun units, and this can win you matches sometimes. Then we have Spectre Tenebria. This girl, probably for some of you, is gonna be lower in the tier list, but in my opinion, she's insanely strong, cause she counter a lot of stuff. She counter Violet, she counter Ram, she counter every single unit now that rely on counter. Then we have Mulet Lilias, he's not out yet, but I'm gonna predict she's gonna be meta, because she's insanely strong, and she's a super strong combo with a lot of heroes, like for example Tenebria. Next we have Lendi, super strong against buffs, but she's now used less and less because of the melee, but yeah, she's still super strong in the meta. Next we have Violet. I hate this guy so much, at least he's falling off a lot, because there are a lot of units that counter evasion, like Milim, Fire Witch Aetheria, the new guy, the Zac, I think. Next we have Ram, she's just super strong, but again, she's countered by Violet, Lendi, or Spectre Tenebria. She's fallen off just a little bit. Politis, she's super strong against a lot of heroes. This girl becomes stronger and stronger the more the units in the game. We have Ran, the fastest initiator in the game, and we have Briar Witch Aetheria. These 2 units together are meta. If you pick them apart, they are just strong heroes, but if you pair them together, they become a super strong combo and they become meta. Then we have Fatal Tenebria, one of my most used units now. She's only countered by things like Mulet Kavarik or Fallen Cecilia, but if you don't have an answer for her, she's just gonna win the match with Yestree. Then Emilia, one of the fastest supports in the game. This girl is just solid. Super Toon Cycle, heal, attack buff, cleanse, she's just strong. Crimson Armin, one of the best knights in the game now. A lot of people just use Crimson Armin instead of Fallen Cecilia because of the Little Queen Charlotte, and she provides more damage mitigation. Next we have Little Queen Charlotte. I think she's just strong because of all these dark heroes in the meta. Against every other thing, she's not that great. Then we have Charlotte. She's super strong against the grass heroes like Violet or Lendi, or even Spectre Tenebria, so she's super solid, she lifesteal, she do a lot of other damage. Then we have the strong tier. These are just strong heroes, but they are not on the same level as the meta heroes, so you are gonna only pick them in the right situation. First one, Mulet Charles. A lot of people just use this guy in the cleave teams, with the Summer Aetheria, the Ran, and so on. Next we have Bloodblade Karin, one of the best cleave units right now. The ability to not be countered is gonna be insanely strong against all these counter units. Next we have Brand Rich Iseria, one of the strongest debuffers in the game right now. She does a lot of damage too, and she's a ranger, so she can be stealth, and she can also counter the Mulet Cowrick. So if you have the Brand Rich Iseria and the enemy has the Cowrick, it just cannot S3, because you're gonna strip everything. She also counters Violet, Dandy, Charlotte, Little Queen Charlotte, which are all top meta heroes. Next we are gonna have the Archnemo's Shadow after the buffs. I'm gonna put her here. I think she's gonna be insanely strong, and she's gonna be used on counter with the new Fairy Delta Nibiru artifact, and she's gonna just be a pain for everybody. Remnant Violet, this guy is kind of stable in the meta right now. Next we have Mulet Ball, he's super strong against things like Angel of Light, and he's also super strong against cliff teams. Operator Secret, she can be used as a damage dealer or as an initiator as a user. She can attack buff, push, and strip, probably one of the best initiators now. Then we have the Mercedes. This girl, when she pop off, is just insane. She just do a lot of damage, especially with attack buff on. Next we have Flan. He's a very good hero for cleave. The only problem with her is she needs to be super fast with a lot of effectiveness, and she also needs something to strip the enemy before she gets a turn. If you don't, she's not gonna defense break the enemy team, and that's your win condition. So yeah, Strays, a tank buster, that's it. It does only damage. Arby is fallen off a lot. I still use this guy, but he's not as before. He's countered by too many units now. Trozet, a super solid knife for a true damage dealer comp. If you want to protect just one of your damage dealer, is the best choice for you. Next we have Milim. A lot of people like her more. I don't really like her though. She's super squishy, so if she doesn't get a turn before your opponent get a turn, she's just gonna die. So yeah, I don't really like her. Next we have Rurel, just solid as always. Then Crow, he's fallen off a lot. Then we have Senya, kind of a solid hero for some situations against squishy damage dealers, like for example Spectre Tenebria. Then we have Edda, people use her in Mage's Cleaves, they pre-ban Belian, and they pick her with things like Ran and Iseria. So yeah, she's a cleave unit. Fatal Zidika, one of my favorite units. She's countered by a lot of stuff now, but she's still a solid unit. SSB, she's back in the meta now. Carrot, she's fallen off a lot for the last season. You only see her sometimes in RTA, but she's still strong. Then we have Last Rider Crow. He's a solid knight, gives immunity, but usually people prefer to pick Crimson Armin or Fallen Cecilia. Next we have the good heroes. These are heroes that you pick if you want to counter some of the enemy picks. First one, Acid, gonna counter cleave teams or mages teams, so it can burn souls. Then we have Blood Moon Haste, it's only gonna be picked against Harvey or Maid Chloe, that's it. Then we have Cerise, a super strong initiator, she can be used in cleave or to counter cleave. Then we are gonna have the new Judge Kisa. I'm gonna put her here in good. I think she's gonna be used as an initiator which strip immunity and reset the enemy cooldown. And probably that is gonna be hit, because the S2 now doesn't do anything. She's gonna just initiate the fight and then die. Mulet Celine, she was used a lot when she came out. Now she's just not seen that much in RTA. She's kind of a counter pick. Mulet Ken, a super strong counter to other damage units like RB and so on, but is countered by a lot of single target nukers now, like Minim, Violet, Riolet. Is also countered by things like Ren, which can ignore effect resistance, or Run. So you're not gonna pick him too many times, but when you pick him, he's gonna do the job. Next we have Elfet, a super strong hero for cleave, but she needs a lot of setup, and cleave is not that strong now in the game. So yeah, I'm gonna put her here. Piltred, another cleave unit, is super strong in cleave, one of the best units in cleave, because it can do damage 2 times with the S3 into S2, and is also gonna provide 12 speed imprint, which is insane. Next we have Elena, a counter to cleave, and yeah, just it. Ruana, a counter to counter units like Belian or SSB, but most Belian have injury on, so they're not gonna care about healing, so yeah, she's not that great now. Pavel used to be the king of cleaves, but with the Angel of Light plus Belian in the game now, he's just kind of a situational pick. General Purgis, this guy was the king of RTA in my last tier list, and now he's just a good unit. Flurry, a solid unit, as always. Luluka, she's probably just a counter to Harvey, you're never gonna see her. Ras, a solid knight, but again, you have better knights now. Mulet Tywin, he's fallen off a lot too. You only see him sometimes with Mulet Tywin lovers. This guy is just a cleave counter or a cleave unit. Tempest Surin, you don't see her at all now. She was super used one season ago, but now she's just not used. Same things with Kisa, she was a Carrot counter, now Carrot is not used, so she's fallen off too. Shuri, a cleave unit, speed imprint, single target nuker, that's it. This guy is another damage dealer counter, but people can just single target, so yeah, he's not as strong now. Selene is another very strong unit. Probably she's gonna be better once Muletilia's coming in the game, as she's gonna be a counter to that. She can probably snipe things like Spectre Tenebria if you play her with the Muletilia's. She can be a good pick in the future. But for now, people just use Politis to counter the same kind of units. Bazaar is falling off a lot, and he needs souls to work. So with the Banyan in the game, he's not gonna be meta. Feather Maya, just a single target nuker, a super tanky unit, that's it. Two counter to control units, but you have the Mulet Cowrick now, so no reason to use these two units. And finally we have Mort in this tier. I'm gonna put him here. I found him sometimes, he does a lot of damage, and he injury a lot too. Then we have the Niche. You're gonna only see these guys sometimes. We have the new hero, Zahak, he's a violet counter, that's it. We have the Luna, which can one-shot two units if the enemy has super squishy units. Then we have the new specialty change, another violet counter. The Sidom, she used in Cleave, but you need to pre-bomb the Belian to use her. Lilias, a solid knight, counter to control the Hen. She's outshined by things like Amelia. The Sinful Angelica, she's a counter to revive, but there are not that many revives in the game now. Not many people use Harpy, so yeah, she's here. Another counter to control, but you can counter this guy even with things like Run. Ravi, she's fallen off a lot, and that's it. The Mui, a decent initiator. A lot of people use her in Guild War defenses, but yeah, she's not used in RTA. The Murid Bazaar, another counter to control, but again, Cowrick. Alencia is still a decent unit. Seed is used in Cleave. A lot of people run him super fast, so he can take your enemy off guard. Assassin Cartuya. Some people use this guy with Violet and Riolet, but now with all these many heroes that counter evasion, he's not that used. And the Assassin Coli, another super strong counter to Cleave, but she's outshined by the Assassin Seed, so yeah, she's not that used. That's gonna be it, guys. This was super long. I've been as fast as possible talking about them. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Let me know what you think in the comments, as always, and I'll see you on the next video. Bye-bye!